हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू यूट्यूब चैनल ऑन इंजीनियरिंग मैथमेटिक्स बाय डॉक्टर नवनीत. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विथ कॉन्स्टेंट कोएफिशिएंट एंड आवर मेन फोकस इज ऑन लर्निंग द कंसेप्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन. सो आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस फुल वीडियो यू विल बी एलिजिबल टू अंडरस्टैंड और टू डिफाइन द लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विथ constant coefficient. Then after watching this video you will be eligible to apply the operator D on linear differential equation, then to define complementary function and to evaluate the complementary function with the help of linear differential equation. So these are the topic learning outcome of the concept complementary function. Now let's define the linear differential equation. An equation of the form nth derivative of y with respect to x plus p1 n minus 1th derivative of y with respect to x plus p2 n minus 2 derivative of y with respect to x plus and so on plus pn minus 1 derivative of y with respect to x plus p and y is equal to capital X. Such type of equation is called as linear differential equation, where in this equation the value p1, this p2 and so on up to pn. So these values are called as constants. So these are the constants in this linear equation. And this capital X, so right hand side value, this capital X is a function of small x. This is the function of small x. So what is the meaning of capital X is a function of small x? Its mean is that capital X may be exponential function, this capital X may be algebraic function, this capital X may be trigonometric function like sin x, cos ax, or this may be tan ax, or it may possible that this capital X is the combination of exponential function and algebraic function, combination of exponential function and trigonometric function and so on. So such type of values are called as the function of x. So it's called linear differential equation. So this is called as linear differential equation, and we are abbreviating this linear differential equation with the term LDE. This LDE stand for linear differential equation. Now let us define the operator D as operator D as D stand for derivative with respect to x. So if we write dy, then its meaning is derivative of y with respect to x. Similarly, if we put the value of d square y, then we get this as second order derivative of y with respect to x. In general, we may write this as d raised to n y is equal to nth order derivative of y with respect to x. So this is called as the operator D. So if we use the operator D in this equation, then this equation becomes, then for our simplicity, let's call this as equation number 1. So now put the value of operator D in this equation. So put the value of this operator D in this equation. So derivative, nth derivative of y with respect to x, nth derivative of y with respect to x is denoted by d raised to n y. So we can write this as d raised to n y plus this is p1, then this is n minus 1th derivative of y with respect to x. We can write this as d raised to n minus 1 y plus this is p2 d raised to n minus 2 y plus and so on plus pn minus 1 dy plus pny is equal to capital X. So this is the new equation we are getting after applying the operator D. So if we observe this equation carefully, in this equation the term y is common from the left hand side. So we can write this as d raised to n plus p1 d raised to n minus 1 plus p2 d raised to n minus 2 plus and so on plus pn minus 1 d plus pn. Now take the term y common is equal to capital X. So now this, observe that this equation is polynomial in terms of d. In school level we already learned that an equation of the form x raised to n plus p1 x raised to n minus 1 and so on plus pn. So such type of equation is called as polynomial equation, and we are denoting this equation by f of x because this is polynomial in terms of x. Similarly, this is also a polynomial equation in terms of d. So let's denote this polynomial by f of d time y is equal to capital X, where this f of d stand for polynomial in terms of d. Then in this equation, if we put the value of right hand side capital X is equal to 0, if this value is equal to 0, then the equation f of d time y is equal to 0, where right hand side is 0, this equation is called, such type of equation is called associated equation. This equation is called as associated equation, and the equation of the form f of d is equal to 0. F of d is equal to 0, that indicate that nth derivative of d raised to n plus p1 d raised to n minus 1 plus p2 d raised to n minus 2 and so on plus pn is equal to 0. Polynomial in terms of p is equal to 0. So such type of equation is called, this equation is called auxiliary equation. Such type of equation is called as auxiliary equation. In short, we are abbreviating this auxiliary equation as AE, where AE stand for auxiliary equation, and this auxiliary equation play a very important role for finding the value of complementary function. So this is called as auxiliary equation of this term. Now this equation has two type of solution. So first solution is called as complementary function. First type of solution is called as complementary function, and second type of solution is called as particular integral. So we are not going in detail about this complementary function and particular theory part. So without loss of generality, please try to understand that complete solution of this equation has two part. First is called as complementary function, and second is called as particular integral. In short, we are denoting complementary function as CS, which is the combination of complementary function CF plus, this is the second part which is called as particular integral, which is called as PI. So abbreviation for complementary function is CF, and abbreviation for particular integral is PI. Or some people may write this as Y is equal to YC, this C stand for complementary function, plus YP, YP stand for the particular integral. Now question is that how to find the value of complementary function and how to find the value of particular integral. Now let's try to understand how to find the value of complementary function first. Understand how to obtain the value of complementary function of linear differential equation. So complementary function is obtained by solving auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is f of d is equal to 0. If we solve this auxiliary equation, then we get the value of complementary function. So depending upon nature of roots, roots of auxiliary equation, depending upon nature of roots of auxiliary equation, following are the three cases. So, to understand the meaning of this auxiliary equation and three cases, let me relate this auxiliary equation with the things which you people already learned during your school days. So हमने स्कूल में पढ़ा है, यदि ये पॉलिनोमियल है x रेस टू n प्लस पी वन एक्स रेस टू एन माइनस वन एंड सो ऑन प्लस पी एन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, यदि ये पॉलिनोमियल है सो ये पॉलिनोमियल के लिए तीन इक्वेशन और तीन टाइप के रूट होते हैं. सो पहला टाइप का रूट ऐसा होता है, सो वी गेट द रूट्स दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रियल एंड नॉन रिपीटेड रूट. सो फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रूट्स वी आर गेटिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रियल एंड नॉन रिपीटेड आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस पॉलिनोमियल. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इक्वेशन इज एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस फाइव एक्स प्लस सिक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इज वन ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल. सो हाउ टू ऑब्टेन द रूट ऑफ दिस क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, फाइंड अ नंबर हुज प्रोडक्ट इज सिक्स एंड एडिशन इज फाइव. सो वी कैन टेक द प्रोडक्ट एज टू इंटू थ्री, सो टू थ्री इज सिक्स, प्रोडक्ट इज सिक्स. इफ वी टेक द एडिशन ऑफ टू नंबर दैन टू प्लस 3 is 5, so addition is 5. That means we can easily get the value of root of this equation as x is equal to minus 2 and minus 3. If we observe this root carefully, then these roots are real, that is no complex part. That means these roots are real and these are different root. Different root means minus 2 and minus 3 are different. So we get the real and non-repeated root after solving such type of polynomial. This is the first case. Now, second case is that we get real and repeated root, real and repeated root. Now to understand this concept, let's take the example of x square plus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. Again, this is one of the polynomial. So to solve this polynomial or to solve this quadratic equation, find a number whose product is 4 and whose addition is again 4. So for this, we can take this as 2 into 2, 4. And if we take the addition of 2 and 2, we get the value as 4. That means the root of this equation is again minus 2 and minus 2. Again, here observe that these roots are real, but these roots are repeated. Minus 2 is repeated twice. So that this root is called as real and repeated. Whereas third case is, so we get imaginary root. Imaginary root, or some people may call this as complex root, real imaginary root or complex root. So for example, if we try to solve the equation x square plus 1 is equal to 0, that means x square is equal to minus 1. So that indicate that x is equal to plus minus I. That means we get the complex root. So these are the three possible cases when we solve the polynomial equation. यानी कि यदि हमने कोई भी पॉलिनोमियल इक्वेशन को सॉल्व किया तो हमें तीन टाइप के रूट मिलते हैं. पहला मिलता है रियल नॉन रिपीटेड, यानी कि हर एक रूट अलग अलग होता है. दूसरा केस मिलता है कि रियल रिपीटेड, यानी कि जो रूट है वो रिपीट हो जाते हैं. सो माइनस टू इज रिपीटेड ट्वाइस. एंड थर्ड केस इज दैट आफ्टर सॉल्विंग एनी पॉलिनोमियल इक्वेशन वी मे गेट सच टाइप ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स रूट. सो सेम कंसेप्ट इज एप्लीकेबल टू ऑक्सिलरी इक्वेशन. सो व्हेनेवर वी सॉल्व सच टाइप ऑफ polynomial in terms of D, then these are the following three cases to get the value of complementary function. So let's discuss the case number one, case first. So first case is that when we solve any polynomial equation, we get real and non-repeated root. So first case is auxiliary equation with real and non-repeated roots. So for this, let's define f of d is equal to 0 and auxiliary equation. Let this be an auxiliary equation. And after solving this auxiliary equation, suppose m1, m2, m3 and so on up to mn. So these are the roots of this auxiliary equation. So we are getting m root because polynomial equation is of order n, and according to the fundamental theorem of algebra, we get the m root for n degree of polynomial. So that's why n roots are there. Then according to theory part, complementary function is c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x plus c3 e raised to m3x plus and so on. This is cn e raised to mnx. So this is the formula for this is the first formula for obtaining the complementary function when roots are real and non-repeated. So in this formula, this value C1, C2, C3 up to CN, these are the constant. This is exponential function. Only put the value of M1, M2, M3 and Mn. Now to understand this first case of complementary function, let's take the example. Suppose example is solve d square y upon dx square plus 5 time dy by dx plus 6y is equal to 0. We will take the same example. Only thing is that x square is replaced by second order derivative. Now if we operate, if we apply the operator d as derivative with respect to x, then we get this as dy means derivative of y with respect to x. Similarly, d square y indicates second order derivative of y with respect to x. If we put this value in this equation, then we get this as d square y plus 5 time dy plus 6y is equal to 0. Again, in this left hand side, y term is common. That means we get this as d square plus 5d plus 6 into y is equal to 0. So then according to the definition of auxiliary equation, so auxiliary equation is d square plus 5d plus 6 is equal to 0. Now question is that to solve this auxiliary equation. To solve this auxiliary equation means find a number whose product is 6 and addition is 5. Again, we know that we just solve this equation, we get the value as minus 2 and minus 3. So here we get the value of d as minus 2 and minus 3. So now observe this root. So observe the value of d. D is minus 2 and minus 3. So these values are real. Moreover, these values are non-repeated because these values are different to each other. So we get the roots which are real and non-repeated. So we get roots are real and non-repeated. So roots are real and non-repeated. Whenever roots are real and non-repeated, then formula for complementary function is C1 e raised to m1x plus C2 e raised to m2x plus and so on plus Cn e raised to mnx. So now here we get the two roots. So let's denote the first root by m1 and denote the second root by m2. Now put the value of m1 and m2 in this equation. So we get this as C1 e raised 2. So value of m1 is minus 2. So this is minus 2x plus C2 e raised 2. So take the value of m2. m2 is minus 3. So we get this as minus 3. So remaining roots are 0. So number 2 is auxiliary equation with real and repeated roots. So we will discuss this case number 2, auxiliary equation with real and repeated root. So let f of d is equal to 0 be a auxiliary equation. Suppose this is the auxiliary equation, and after solving this auxiliary equation, suppose m1, m2 up to mn are the roots of this equation. That means after solving this equation, we get such type of n root of this auxiliary equation. And let's assume that two roots m1 is equal to m2. Suppose assume that first two roots are equal. That means two roots are repeated. In this case, the value of complementary function is C1 plus C2x then e raised to m1x plus C3 e raised to m3x and so on. So this is the value of complementary function when two roots are repeated. Suppose assume that three roots are repeated. M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M3. That means if three roots are repeated, in this case, the formula of complementary function become C1 plus C2x plus C3 x square then e raised to M1x plus C4. This is constant C1, C2, C3. Next constant is C4. Then this is e raised to M4x and so on. So this is the formula when three roots are repeated. Similarly, we can extend this formula for four roots get repeat, five roots get repeat and so on. Now to understand the concept of auxiliary equation with real and repeated root. Let's take the first example. So we will take the same example as that of this one. So example is solve d square y upon dx square plus 4 time dy by dx plus 4y is equal to 0. So this example and this polynomial is same. This example and this polynomial is same. Only x is replaced by second order derivative. If we apply the operator d, then this become d square y plus 4 time dy plus 4y is equal to 0. If we take the term y common, then we get the auxiliary equation as, so auxiliary equation is d square plus 4d plus 4 is equal to 0. Again, this is one of the polynomial equation. So to solve this polynomial equation in terms of d, find a number whose product is 4 and addition is 4. This equation also called as quadratic equation. Find a number whose product is 4 and addition is 4. So we can write this as 2 into 2 is 4, moreover 2 plus 2 is 4. That means we get the value of d as minus 2 and minus 2. That means here these roots are real. That means no complex part, no imaginary part I is present. That's why these roots are real. Moreover, these two roots are repeated, minus 2 and minus 2 repeated is twice. That means suppose this is the value of m1 and this is the value of m2. So here the value of m1 is equal to value of m2. So in this case, the value of complementary function is, so value of complementary function is, so this is c1 plus c2x e raised to m1x plus c3 e raised to m3x and so on. So put the value of m1 and m2 in this equation. So we get complementary function as c1 plus c2x then e raised to minus 2x. So in this way we get the value of complementary function when auxiliary equation with real and repeated root. So this is your case number 2 for obtaining the complementary function. Now let's discuss the case number 3. Now case number 3 is auxiliary equation with complex or imaginary root. So let's assume that alpha plus minus I beta. Assume that alpha plus minus I beta are the roots of auxiliary equation after solving the auxiliary equation. Then in this case, the value of complementary function is e raised to alpha x in bracket c1 cos of beta x plus c2 sine of beta x. That means put the value of alpha here and put the value of beta here, irrespective of the sign of plus and minus of this complex number. So this is the formula for obtaining the complementary function when roots are complex or imaginary root. Again, it may possible that complex root also may get repeat. So for repeated root, for repeated complex root, formula for complementary function is e raised to alpha x, then similar to that of the case number 2. So we get this as c1 plus c2x, then this is cos of beta x plus c3 plus c4x into sine of beta x. So this formula is for the non-repeated complex number and this formula is for the repeated complex number for getting the complementary function. Now let's explain this first and second formula with the help of example. So now example for this is that solve, suppose first example is d cube y upon dx cube minus d square y upon dx square plus 3 time dy by dx plus 5 time y is equal to 0. Let's take this as the one example. So if we convert this example in terms of operator d, then we get this as d cube minus d square plus 3d plus 5 time y equal to 0. After applying the operator d, we can easily write this equation. So now the auxiliary equation of this term is, auxiliary equation is d cube minus d square plus 3d plus 5 is equal to 0. So now this is the polynomial equation in terms of D with the power 3. Whenever power is 3, then use the synthetic division. So we know that how to use the synthetic division. So in the basic lecture of this lecture series, we already learned the method that is called as synthetic division method for finding the roots of cubic equation. Now first thing is that write down the power of D in decreasing power. So this is D cube, D square, D and D raised to 0. So write down the coefficient of this term, 1, this is minus 1, 3 and 5. So our expected answer is that remainder must be 0. So then check the value of alternative coefficient. So whether we have to take plus 1, minus 1, plus 2, minus 2 or plus 3, minus 2. So to choose this number, use the rule of synthetic division. So if we take the sum of alternative coefficient, sum of alternative coefficient is 1 and 3 is 4. Again, sum of next alternative coefficient is minus 1 and 5, that means 4. Sum of alternative coefficient is 4. So that's why minus 1 is the root. So that's why we choose this value as minus 1. So take this number as it is. So this number as it is. So 1 into minus 1, we get this as minus 1. So take the addition of these two number. So this is minus 2. So this is minus 2 and again minus 1. So final answer is 2. So 3 plus 2, answer is 5. So if we take the product of these two number, then 5 and minus 1, that means minus 5. So now here 5 and minus 5, remainder is 0. That means D is equal to minus 1 is the factor of this equation. Now if we apply the synthetic division method and if we try to solve this equation, then we may write this as D plus 1. So write down the opposite sign of this equation. Then this 1 minus 2 and 5 can be written as, so this is D square minus 2D plus 5 is equal to 0. So product of two number is 0, then either one of them must be 0. According to this rule, so either the value of D plus 1 is equal to 0 or D square minus 2D plus 5 is equal to 0. So this first equation is very simple to solve. So if we solve the first equation, then we can easily get the value of D as minus 1. So again, if we observe this second equation, this is quadratic equation. So according to the quadratic equation method, so we may find the number whose product is 5 and addition is minus 2, or we may apply the direct formula of quadratic equation. So if we apply the formula, standard formula of quadratic equation, then we get the value of D as minus B. That means minus minus become plus. So plus 2 plus minus root of B square minus 2 square, that is 4, minus 4 into A, value of A is 1, into C, value is 5, divided by 2 into value of A is 1. So if we simplify this equation, then we get this as 2 plus minus, then this is 4 minus 4, 5 is at 20. That means we get this as minus 60 upon 2. Moreover, we get this as 2 plus minus, this is 4i upon 2, which is equal to 1 plus minus 2i. So we get the complex root here. So now here we observe that roots are complex. So here root of complex because of the imaginary part I. So if we compare this root 1 plus minus 2i with the number alpha plus minus I beta. So if we compare this with the term alpha plus minus beta I, then we get the value of alpha as 1 and that of beta as 2. Then according to the complementary function formula, so we can write the complementary function as e raised to alpha x in bracket c1 cos of beta x plus c2 sine of beta x. So now here only put the value of alpha and beta in this equation, we get the complementary function of this equation. Now so this can be written as complementary function is equal to e raised to, so value of alpha is 1, so this is 1 into x in bracket this c1 is constant into this is cos of beta, so value of beta is 2, so cos of 2x plus c2 sine of again 2x. So in this way we get the value of complementary function when roots are complex, or we may call this as imaginary root. So this is the example where roots are non-repeated in complex case. Now let's take the one example where roots are repeated in complex case. Now take the next example where solve d raised to 4y upon dx raised to 4 plus 6 time d square y upon dx square plus 9y is equal to 0. So again, this is the linear differential equation. If we apply the operator d, then this can be written as d raised to 4 plus 6 time d square plus 9y equal to 0 after applying the operator d. Then auxiliary equation is d raised to 4 plus 6 d square plus 9 is equal to 0. So this is the auxiliary equation. Now observe that this equation order is 4, so that means d raised to 4. So how to obtain the equation of order 4? We learn during the basic results of our lecture series. So now here, so if we observe this equation carefully, then this equation is the perfect square of d square plus 3 its square equal to 0. So if we make the square of this equation, then we get this equation as it is. That means this is the perfect square of this equation. Then we can write this as d plus 3 is equal to 0, and we can write this as d square plus 3 is equal to 0. So if we solve this equation, then we get this as d is equal to minus 3. Again here we get the value of d square is equal to minus 3. So if we find the root of this equation, then we get this as plus minus 3i. Again here we get the value of d as plus minus 3i. Now observe the type of roots. So what type of roots we are getting here? So these roots are plus minus 3i. This is again plus minus 3i. So because of this I term, these roots are called as complex root, and these roots are repeated. Whenever complex and repeated root is we are getting, that in this case apply the value of complementary function as e raised to alpha x and so on. This formula is applicable for obtaining the complementary function. Now these roots are real and repeated, so we can write this as roots are complex. So these roots are complex. Then so first root is plus minus 3i, and again second root is plus minus 3i. Now question is that what is the value of alpha and what is the value of beta? So we can write this as alpha plus minus beta I, and this is alpha plus minus beta I. If we compare this roots with this standard formula, then here the value of alpha is 0. So value of alpha is 0 and that of beta is 3. Then according to the complementary function formula for repeated root, we can write this as e raised to alpha x c1 plus c2x cos of beta x plus c3 plus c4x into sine of beta x. So this formula of complex number is applicable. Now put the value here, so we get this as e raised to 0x. Then this is c1 plus c2x. This c1 and c2 are the constant. Then cos of, put the value of beta. Value of beta is 3. So cos of 3x plus again c3 plus c4 are constant into sine of beta. Value of beta is again 3. So in this way, we get the value of complementary function when complex roots are repeated. So now, in this way, we learn the concept that is called as complementary function. Now let's summarize this concept. Now let's summarize the concept complementary function. So complementary function. So complementary function is obtained by solving the auxiliary equation f of d is equal to 0. So after solving this auxiliary equation, we get the complementary function. So depending upon roots of this complementary function, there are three cases. So first case is that, so when we solve the auxiliary equation, and after solving auxiliary equation we get real and repeated root, that means auxiliary equation with real and non-repeated roots. When we get real and non-repeated root, then formula for complementary function is, so c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x and so on plus cn e raised to mnx. So this is the formula for obtaining the auxiliary equation when roots are real and non-repeated. Now in second case we learned that auxiliary equation with real and repeated roots, when roots are repeated, real and repeated root. So then suppose assume that first two roots are repeated, that means m1 is equal to m2. So in this case, so complementary function is obtained by c1 plus c2x, then e raised to m1x plus c3, e raised to m3x plus and so on. So this formula is applicable when roots are repeated. If two roots are repeated, then this is the formula. If three roots are repeated, that means assume that m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m3. When three roots are repeated, then complementary function is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square, then e raised to m1x plus constant is c1, c2, c3, now constant is c4, then e raised to m4x and so on. So these are, this is the formula which is applicable when roots are repeated. Now in case 3 we learned that, in case 3 we learned that auxiliary equation with complex, or we may call this as imaginary roots. When auxiliary equation with complex and imaginary roots are there, then complementary function is equal to e raised to alpha x, then c1 cos of beta x plus c2 sine of beta x. Now this formula is applicable when complex roots are non-repeated. If complex root are repeated, then complementary function is e raised to alpha x, then this is c1 plus c2x cos of beta x plus c3 plus c4x into sine of beta x. This formula is applicable when roots are repeated. So in this way we get the value of complementary function for solving the linear differential equation. Friends, I hope you people like this lecture. Thanks one and all.